New Zealand is known around the world for its big-name tourist attractions, Queenstown, Rotorua, Bay of Islands.
But it's not often our small towns get recognised. One in particular has just been named one of the most beautiful small towns in the world. Here's Julian Lee.
They're the crowd behind Vogue, The New Yorker, GQ and Vanity Fair. Condé Nast. And they recently published a list of the most beautiful small towns in the world. Only one New Zealand town made it. And it's not Arrowtown, or Russell, or even Shannon.
The place used to be where you stopped for a, you know, a pea and a pie, but now people come here for our hospitality and our coffee.
Kevin Hayes, former mayor, former radio station boss, former bloody everything.
I can walk 20 metres down the beach and catch a salmon. You know, I can walk 30 metres down the beach and catch whitebait. That's from my house, you know. Where else can you get that? We're all good passes. I think really it's our people that make the place really what it is, along with all this, you know? I mean, why wouldn't you?
What are the people like, and why are they different from other folk?
Well, some of them are different, all right, pal. But between us and Christchurch, which is our sort of our nearest city, obviously, and north to Blenheim, there are big hills to get over, so we can sort of get away with stuff that maybe other people can't.
Like what?
Well, you know, I don't want to get into specifics, obviously, but the interrelationships between the people that have gone on here has been quite intense over the last century. There's a lot of cousins here. You know what I mean?
There's sort of a Mission Bay vibe along there.
It's unfortunate, isn't it, really? But, we don't want to turn into another Queenstown. We don't want to be another Mount Maunganui or another Mission Bay. The people that have lived here for generations, that's how they want it. They want it to move slowly. They don't want to wake up in the morning and there's a building where there wasn't one there yesterday sort of stuff.
One thing about Kai Koura is the constant seagull noise.
They're here in abundance. And people realise because you walk down the road with a sausage roll, and it's gone, you know? you eat it before you leave.
We caught up with some old schoolmates from Hamilton on a trip.
It's different, I guess, than home than Hamilton anyway. We don't ever miss in Hamilton.
No, it's lovely. Look at it. We would just sit and have a beer like this and look at that.
Yeah, been up here many times. Yeah, it is a great place.
You don't really get places like this in the North Island, do you?
In the North Island?
Yeah,
you do. The Bay of Plenty's pretty awesome.
I don't think there's anything that we don't show off, you know. We're not hiding anything.
But something was bothering me. It's something Kev had mentioned in passing at the pub the night before. As it turns out, Kai Koura is hiding something at the old whaling station.
Get the whales out here in the ocean, harpoon them up, they float when they're dead, drag them in the channel and up to the beach, and that's where they would slaughter them.
And the site of none other than New Zealand's oldest concrete, our very own Great Wall of Aotearoa.
This is the first wharf built in Kai Koura out of the first concrete that was ever made in New Zealand.
This is the oldest concrete in New Zealand, right here.
Right here.
Right here. How do you make concrete?
Out of lime, I think. Lime's part of the ingredients of cement, and of course our peninsula's full of limestone.
Do you feel in a special place when you come here and stand on New Zealand's oldest concrete?
Well, concrete's sort of not really done anything for me, really, so.
Do we do anything to the concrete? Is there any ritual or
no.
Lean down and maybe, you know?
Oh, I suppose you could, yeah. Oh my word.
Maybe I should, it should even be more of a prostrate, I think, like more of a, like how they really, you know?
Sort of more of a hug, really. I know a few people have kissed a bit of concrete in their day, but it wasn't probably because they wanted to.
The Blarney Stone of the South Pacific. The very foundational block of our fine country.